Good morning, everyone. As president of your college council, I will be chairing today's annual meeting. Before I begin our meeting today, I'd like to go over a few housekeeping items. I'd first like to note that the PowerPoint presentation from the keynote address is available for download on the college's website. There's also a link to a post-event survey available on the college website for you to complete afterwards. Following today's event, we encourage you to complete this survey, at which point you will have access to a link to enter your personal information and print out for your records. Today's annual meeting and keynote address will be recorded and will be available for viewing on the coming weeks on our website and YouTube channel. The recordings will include closed captioning to ensure that they are fully accessible to our members and stakeholders. An e-bulletin to members and other stakeholders will be sent out once these recordings are available. Please keep an eye out for these important communications. Later this morning, we will have a question period, at which time we will call for questions from our membership. Members will be able to participate in the question period by entering their questions in the call for questions field at the bottom of the webpage you're currently on. You may submit your questions at any time throughout the morning. If there are more questions than time permits, the college team will respond to those questions by email over the next 2 weeks. In order to accommodate questions from as many members as possible this morning, we would ask that you limit yourself to one question only. If you require any assistance during this morning's meeting, please email communications@ocswssw.org. Now, let's begin our annual meeting portion of the meeting, in the morning, sorry. Notice having been given and quorum being present, I call this meeting to order. It is my great pleasure to welcome you to our 2020 annual meeting of the Ontario College of Social Workers and Social Service Workers. We are hosting this year's annual meeting and keynote address entirely online due to the ongoing impacts related to COVID-19 pandemic. While the annual meeting is an essential regulatory event, the safety of college staff, members and other stakeholders remains our top priority during this challenging time. And just so you all know, there's currently 7 people wearing masks in our boardroom, and for the first time in my life, I think I would welcome a room of 500. So it's a little different this year. The Ontario College of Social Workers and Social Service Workers acknowledges the history of the land on which we are gathered. This land is the traditional territory of many nations, including the Mississaugas of the New Credit, the Anishinaabeg, the Chippewa, the Haudenosaunee, and the Wendat's peoples. The college's offices, where we are hosting today's meeting, is in the Dish With One Spoon territory, which is a treaty between the Anishinaabeg, Mississaugas, and the Haudenosaunee that bound them to share the memory, the territory, and protect the land and memory of the spirit of community. Today, the province of Ontario is home to many diverse First Nations, Inuit and Métis peoples, from the Cree and the northern reaches of the Delaware in the south. Each nation is unique in their beliefs, languages, and histories, and we gather here in the spirit of openness with a commitment to continue to recognize and reflect upon the important work ahead. Through its new strategic plan, College Council has indicated its commitment to moving forward on the challenging and very important issues of diversity, inclusion and equity as they relate to the college's regulatory role. This overarching priority encompasses the anti-Black and anti-Indigenous racism and other forms of systemic oppression which disproportionately affect racialized communities. Within this priority, the college has made a commitment to developing partnerships with Indigenous communities in order to begin to implement the Truth and Reconciliation Commission of Canada's call to action within the regulatory context. In doing so, we recognize that reconciliation is an ongoing and collective individual and collective process. My apologies. As we prepared for today's meeting, I must say how pleased we are to have so many college members and other stakeholders joining us online. I am pleased to also share with you that the Honourable Todd Smith, Minister of Children, Community and Social Services, has provided video greetings and opening remarks for our 2020 annual meeting. Born and raised in Riverview, New Brunswick, Minister Smith has lived in the Belleville area since the early 90s. A graduate of Loyalist College, he embarked on a 16-year career in radio news broadcasting. In 2011, Minister Smith was nominated to run as the Progressive Conservative candidate provincially and was successfully elected. In June 2018, he was elected in the New Bay of Quinte riding as part of a Progressive Conservative majority government. Premier Doug Ford named him Government House Leader and Minister of Government and Consumer Services. In November 2018, he was named Minister of Economic Development, Job Creation and Trade while remaining Government House Leader. As of last June, he sits as Minister of Children, Community and Social Services. Beyond politics, Minister Smith has been active with numerous charitable and community causes. He is a past chair of Operation Red Nose Quinte, and he has volunteered as a hockey coach for several years. Amid all of his commitments, Minister Smith's family remains his most important priority. He enjoys spending time with his wife, Tanya, a local high school teacher, and his daughters, Peyton and Reagan. Thank you, Minister Smith, for providing video remarks for today's annual meeting. Please join me in viewing Minister Smith's remarks.
Hi everyone, I'm Todd Smith, Ontario's Minister of Children, Community and Social Services. It's great to be here and welcome you to this year's AGM and Education Day. Although we're all meeting virtually these days, I know that we still will enjoy the experience of sharing ideas and learning together. I'd also like to congratulate the college and all of its members on your 20th anniversary. The work you do and the services you provide are vitally important, and they grow greater in importance each year. For two decades, the college has created a strong regulatory framework that serves and protects the public. But we know that it's much more than that. It provides opportunities for ongoing education, engagement, and leadership on critical social and health issues. Over the past couple of months, our lives have changed drastically, and this has really only further highlighted the important role that social workers and social service workers play in Ontario. It's demanded that you work in completely different ways, without that personal face-to-face connection that can be so vital in those relationships with your clients. I want to thank all of you for continuing to find innovative ways to deliver consistency and care, and I applaud you for all that you do. The work you're doing strengthens Ontario's peoples and communities. Thank you and have a great day.
Thank you again, Minister Smith. I would now like to take a moment to welcome our colleagues from the professional associations who are joining us today via live stream. DP Sewer, the Chief Executive Officer of the Ontario Association of Social Workers, and Barb Baker, the President of the Ontario Social Service Workers Association. We're very pleased to have you joining us today and welcome. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge our council and non-council members who perform a critical function in helping the college meet its statutory obligations and objectives. Our college council includes public members John Fleming, Karen Fromm, Faiza Khalid Khan, Lisa Christakis, Andy Kusiapai, Pamela Murphy, and Deirdre Smith. Our registered social service workers on council include Amanda Betancourt, Charlene Cruz, Angèle Desarmeaux, Judy Gardner, Mukesh Kalasar, and Sue Ellen Merritt. Registered social workers are Kenta Asakura, Sanjay Govindaraj, Francis Keogh, Tula Korgiantakis, Donald Panton, Vinita Puri, and Lisa Seaburn. I would also like to thank the non-council members who serve on the statutory and non-statutory committees of the college. Non-council members in the social work category include Rita Silverthorne and Isabella Thompson. Social service work members include Greg Clark. Thank you all for your hard work and dedication. Before I begin my report, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge that this year marks the college's 20th anniversary. Admittedly, this isn't the celebration we had hoped to celebrate this milestone, but we know that you understand that safety remains a top priority for everyone. The college's continued growth and success over the years would not have been possible without the hard work and dedication of council and the excellent college team. In particular, I would like to recognize past council presidents, some of whom are joining us today. Rachel Birnbaum, Christine Forsyth, Mukesh Kalasar, Claudia Newman, Bob Thompson, Diane Thompson, and Beatrice Traub-Warner. On behalf of the college, thank you. Thank you for your leadership and guidance in shaping what the college is in 2020. it would be impossible to mark the college's 20th anniversary without mentioning our founding registrar, Glenda MacDonald, who passed away on May 25th, 2015. Today's event, which is a scaled-down version of the college's annual meeting and education day, is part of the Glenda MacDonald Education Series, named in honor of Glenda and her wholehearted dedication to the work of the college. On behalf of the College Council, I would now like to report briefly on some of the college's activities and highlights from 2019. As the regulatory body for social workers and social service workers in Ontario, the Ontario College of Social Workers and Social Service Workers is committed to protecting the public interest. We fulfill our public protection mandate by ensuring that our members provide professional and ethical care and services, and that we are accountable to the public we serve. Last year was a time of transition for the college. We concluded our 2016-2019 strategic plan, and having achieved many of the objectives within the four strategic priorities. These priorities included strengthening stakeholder and public awareness, upholding ethical and professional practice, maintaining effective governance, and achieving regulatory effectiveness. We maintained effective governance by promoting a culture of diversity, inquiry, and accessibility. Last year, College Council approved bylaw amendments which increased the transparency of the online register and others which permitted the development of campaign guidelines for candidates running for election for council. We continue to engage in ongoing and regular communication with other Canadian social work regulators around a range of matters such as registration and mobility, electronic and other practice issues, continuing competence, and complaints and discipline. We also provided comments on a number of issues to regulatory colleagues, including the College of Nurses of Ontario, the College of Psychologists of Ontario, the College of Kinesiologists of Ontario, and the College of Massage Therapists of Ontario. The College's Registrar and CEO, Lise Betteridge, participated in the Council of Licensure, Enforcement and Regulation, Conference Planning, and Executive Leadership Program Committees. Lise was also re-elected to the Canadian Council of Social Work Regulators, and our college's Deputy Registrar, Laura Sheehan, was appointed to the National Program Planning Committee of the Canadian Network of Agencies for Regulation. These are all tongue tires, and the acronyms are much easier. The college's senior team also presented on various issues and initiatives and participated in a number of key discussions throughout 2019. At the end of 2019, the college embarked on a strategic planning process to identify the future direction and priorities of the college for the next 4 years. The result of this process is our newly approved 2020 to 2023 strategic plan, which you would have received information about by email, and it is on our website if you haven't viewed it already. The new strategic plan outlines the following four strategic priorities: uphold ethical and professional practice, strengthen stakeholder engagement and government relations, increase diversity, inclusion, and equity, enhance regulatory effectiveness. Throughout the strategic planning process, the college carefully considered stakeholder feedback in order to ensure that the new strategic plan provides clarity with respect to the college's direction and priorities moving forward. In terms of next steps, the college will implement and measure our progress towards each of the priorities and objectives set out in the strategic plan. And the strategic plan will be operationalized on an annual basis through budget and work plans. We look forward to sharing with you the progress of the 2020-2023 strategic plan in the years ahead throughout College Council meeting highlights, e-bulletins, annual reports, and other communications from the college.